discuss the concept of finding the sum of n terms of an AP when the AP is given to us and the last term of the AP is also given to us. That means we have been given the AP A1, A2, A3 and AN. All the terms, first, second, third term and the last term of an AP is given to us and we are supposed to find the sum of terms. So for this we will use the formula SN is equal to N by 2 A plus N. Now A is equal to A1 and L is equal to A of N. That means A is given to us, L is given to us. If we know the value of N, we can find the value of SN. So to find the value of N, we will use the formula for the general term of an AP, or we can say that A1 is equal to the first term, that is A, and A2 is equal to A plus D. A3 is equal to A plus 2D. Using this concept, we can find the value of D, that means A2 minus A1 is D. Similarly, A2 minus A1 is also D. That means A3 minus A2 is equal to D, A2 minus A1 is equal to D. As we know the value of A1, A2, A3, because the AP has been given to us, we can find the value of D. Using this value of D, we can find the value of N. So, because we know that A of N is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Now, we know the value of A, we know the value of D, we know the value of AN. Because AN has been given to us, A is the first term of the AP and D is the common difference that we have just found out. So, using these three values, we can find the value of N. Once we know the value of N, we can use this formula to find the sum of N terms of an AP. Because the AP was given to us and the last term was given to us, so we try to find the sum of N terms by first calculating the common difference. And using the common difference, we try to calculate the value of N for AN, and using that value, we will find the sum of N terms of the AP. Now let us try to apply the concept of finding the sum of n terms when the AP is given to us and the last term is given to us. Suppose we are given the AP as 34, 32, 30 and the last term is 10 and we are supposed to find the sum of these terms. That means now the AP has been given to us and the last term has been given to us, we are supposed to find the sum of n terms. For this, as we have just discussed, we will first try to find the common difference, because we know that A1 is equal to 34, A2 is equal to 32 and A3 is equal to 30. Now D is equal to A3 minus A2, that is 30 minus 32, this is equal to minus 2. Also we will calculate D as A2 minus A1, which will be 32 minus 34, again minus 2. So the common difference is minus 2 and the last term is 10. That means A of N is equal to 10, or we can say A plus N minus 1 into D is equal to 10, because the value of last term is given to us as 10. So we have substituted the value of A will be 34 plus N minus 1 into minus 2 is equal to 10, or we can say 34 and minus 2N plus 2 is equal to 10. Or minus 2n plus 36 is equal to 10, or we can say minus 2n is equal to 10 minus 36. So we can say minus 2n is equal to minus 26. Minus will cancel out, n is equal to 13. That means now we know the value of n, we know the value of the last term, we know the value of the first term. So that means A is equal to 34. L is equal to 30 and we will use the formula SN is equal to N by 2 A plus N. Now we know the value of N, we know the value of A, we know the value of L. We will substitute these values and we will calculate the value of the sum. That means now N is 13, 13 upon 2, A is 34 and L is 10. L is 10 in this. So 13 upon 2 is equal to 44. Or we can say 13 into 22, which will be equal to 13 into 22 into 3 is 66, 6 carry, 22 into 1 is 22 and 6 is 28. So 286, S of N is equal to 286, when the first term is 34 and the last term is 10. That means the AP is 34, 32, 30 and the last term is 10. So we have applied the concept to calculate the sum of n terms when the AP is given to us and the last term is given to us. For this we have first calculated the value of the common difference. For this I have taken A1 as 34, A2 as 32 and A3 as 30 because these were the first three terms of the AP. And then we calculated the value of D. We verified the value of D for the next expression. That means we calculated D using A3 minus A2. And then we verified whether it is an AP or not by finding the value of D from the expression A2 minus A1. In both the cases, the value of D was minus 2. So we used this value of D as minus 2 in the value of AN because we know that AN is 10. Now we substituted the value of A, D and A of N and we tried to find the value of N and we found the N to be 13. Now we know the value of the first term A. We know the value of the last term L, that is 10, and we know the number of terms N, that is 13. So we use the formula Sn is equal to N by 2 A plus L and we substituted all the values and then calculated and we found that the sum of N terms was 286. So this is how we can apply the concept of finding the sum of N terms when the AP is given to us and the last term is also given to us.